So here we are in Pandemonium. We're going to try and get a sixth rune. We are on a 5-win streak. This is our sixth character. So if we can get 6 runes, consider that doing our duty. Hop out of line of sight. Tower Shield of Protection, pick it up. Mechazex, no good. Alright, that's probably where the Pandemonium is. Demon Spawn Corruptor, they can corrode and they can summon lots of bad things, so let's do the offensive hop. The Black Sun is immune to cold, but the Corruptor isn't, and neither is the Green Death. Absorbing vital energy, so what happens if we just use Borgnors? Restricted by zombie hands. Okay, that seems cool. Enemies killed. Wonder what our high score with Kazlaw was. We've never won with Kazlaw. Wow. Highest we got was a Minotaur Monk. Wow, I didn't know that. Kinda changes the way about things. It would be really nice to get more gen. Random slow is probably especially bad on a character that's predisposed to be surrounded by enemies. Like perhaps even we should get an axe, because we have some pretty baller axe. Like we have the +8 frozen axe. Base damage is 18, so it's somewhat more than the Evening Star. I don't know that we really want it. The Hell Sentinel. Affected by Bullet Rumor, but picked up, you know, regen when monsters are around. Oh, here's the Pan Lord. We have Abjuration and Lightning Bolt. And Summon Demon. Alright, let's use Borgnors on him. Make him easier to hit. And, wow. Dead already. Levels. Ooh, that's bad. So we should have done this a while ago. We saw that Ice Fiend. We should have done something about it, since they have Symbol of Torment. Yeah, thanks, awesome. Nice save. It was not playing very well, is what it was. No casting spells because we're sapped. need 4 charges of paralysis. We have some ruined glass doors. Inside we have our pain board that has harpoon shot, susceptible to cold. So let's open it and let's play the freezing cloud game. Let's see the clouds go away. Spinal clutch. Use upheaval on this reaper. Should have done that. Alright, boots of flying. Yes, we'll take those. Book of the Tundra. And portal to another part of Pan. So the boots that we're wearing have resist electricity. So getting the flying boots, it's not really worth it. All right, on to Pan. And some other level. Some other level where there is no room. What can we say? So let's just switch levels. Let's get this Noxinol taken care of. The Book of Lightning. Get Maxwell's Capacitive Coupling, which we will not use. Almost seems like this should be a special pain level, but there's no room here. It's not that we can tell. Okay, we're marked. Let's cancel that. Tremor stones, we'll take some of those out. Running a little low. That's okay. Get the cherub here. Demon's Bone Corruptor. Ice Beam, so go straight into statue form until we take the Ice Fiend out. Something is summoning things. Okay, it's the shadow. Alright, so the Ice Fiend's dead. How do we get the Shadow Demon? We cast Upheaval. We don't have enough mana to do that a whole lot. We could tin the Tremor Stones again. That sounds like a good one. Let's almost dead. I'll just walk up next to him. Another one. So let's use condenser vein. Sap, so no spells. Ooh. Some fighting, all right. That's why it has all so difficult. So here we got our Pan Ward, Firestorm, Force Lance, Orb of Destruction. So we're going to file Floods, and then we're going to summon a Mana Viper that we miscast. Let's check our message log. Slow. Alright, let's swap places with our Mana Viper. That didn't work. Let's try it again. No, just getting Firestorm over and over. But we did take out the Pan Lord. We were in the cloud, so. Alright, so rest up and go to another level of pain. Scroll blinking light off. Okay. Ice fiend right next to us. And a demon spawn, corrupt, or some many, many awful things. Let's teleport. And as much as we want to kill this ice fiend, let's hop away. Okay. Wow. We gotta get out of this pin level. Here's the gateway. Alright, there's a rune here. So let's read a magic mapping. So we know where it is. The rune's probably down there. Maybe it's in here. Hard to say. Let's stay over to the right. Black Sun, Blood Saint. Okay. Let's hop right in the bottom. Archmage, juice to us. So instead of killing this large abomination, I'm waiting until this Hell Sentinel is adjacent, so that we don't get the damnation. And unlike the Abyss, we don't need to rush. Like, we can just hide out, basically. The enemies will come to us, and once they come to us, we don't have much more to be afraid of. In the Abyss, you kind of have to charge. Scarf of Resistance. Nice. Black Suns are immune to cold, right? Yeah. Well, we can still upheaval them. Get a box of these now. Let's cancel the mark. And get weird blood going again. Let's hop towards the brimstone thing. Do you have a potion of invisibility? Hey, there's the room. We'll just grab it. We don't even have to destroy the ice statues. The only reason those ice statues were getting destroyed is because of our reflection. So let's scroll down there again. Put that right there, that's our sixth. Yeah. Acid charges. Nice, we're almost out of those. Alright, Let's see what's... Lots of Blizzard Demons, Handlord. Well, we've probably already gotten the most valuable gear. Let's head up here and see. Yeah, there's no other gear that's better, so there's no reason. We're just asking for trouble. Alright, so new level of pan. In statue form, we're gonna upheaval on the ice fiend. We're gonna walk closer to the ice fiend. Deva fighting us. We're still in statue form. We're gonna read a teleport scroll. We're gonna get out of statue form. Nice. Let's go through the gate. We're trying to find a way out. If we happen to come across, another way, we'll evaluate. But our goal right now is just to get out. Oh, Pandemonium is hard to get out of because there's lots of portals that take you to other Pandemonium levels, but there's not many portals that take you out. There are sometimes you can find a portal that takes you into the Abyss. Hey, Paralysis Wand. Nice. And going to the Abyss does count as exiting Pandemonium. Tormentors. let's see if we can find what we're looking for. Gates to different areas of pain. You know, even though we don't have lesser beckoning, this hop is pretty cool. Here's our pain board that's conjuring ball lightning. That doesn't look fun. I can't blink or anything, so let's go Berserk Rage. It gives us lots of extra HP, which we'll need. Wow, I think they killed themselves with the ball lightning, honestly. Multiple tormentors. Looks like there's already four portals, so we're probably not gonna find a portal to the abyss. For some reason, I think there can only be four portals. But we'll explore it just to be safe. Even though this is a pretty dangerous level. Can cast freezing climb in here. Just wait. So we use Borgnor's Vile Clutch. It seems to be pretty effective, actually. Looks like the Brimstone Fiend is almost going to be killed by a Breeze of Cloud. Typically, this can be a pretty difficult vault. Because you gotta walk through lots and lots of demons. But there is treasure. It's the possibility of treasure. Freezing Cloud's the only thing we can do besides upheaval. LRD is a good thought, good point. Can also use manifold assault. So we shouldn't forget about that. Okay, well, no super great treasure, but got the experience anyway. Alright, new level of pain. 22. Try and hop next to them. Traps. Pain or has blinked close. Or ignores file clutch. Help with the evasion. Radiate, nice. Pain mode down. Ice rings. A portal to another region. Damn, these ice fiends. This is an extremely difficult PM up on here. I guess we're going to go into a different region. Looks like we got some fleshy walls. We need the Angel Pan level. Like it. Let's read magic mapping. So pretty cool level. Apis and Deva. Okay, it doesn't seem so bad. The smiting is not so great. These are all gates to another region. And I was hoping one of them would be a gate out. Just waiting this angel out in the freezing cloud and reflecting Sacred Scourge of Holy Wrath. It's damage 12, so it's less than the Evening Star. We'll pick it up anyhow. But do we get greedy? And do we clear this last level? At the chances of finding so this is Holy Pan. Having an okay time killing these. Mostly because we're not a mummy. Or a vampire. Or a ghoul. Basically because we're not undead. open. Alright, so it looks like we've explored around the outside of these vaults. +1 buckler of Zetu. Micro-press. Potion incantation though, which is. Lots of cancellation potions. So now let's go to other area 1. Meanwhile, we'll clear out some of these enemies. Alright, give ourselves a little dragon. It's holy, bro. Scroll of brand weapon. Let's go ahead and read it. And instead of Vampiric, we now get Electrocution. We'll switch to that. So I'm glad if it was good tactics that we've been around trying to clear stuff out before we went and started going to the main entrance. Any more enemies come out, I'm gonna wanna hop away. Looks like we're doing okay though. Book of Flames, we got what we need. And we got some Mind Burst charges. It's time to go into the inner part as well. Multiple angels, a seraph. That can do some pretty nasty things. So let's close the door and teleport. Alright, so now let's get a little closer. We'll try and fight them one by one. Pretty scary. Seraphs. Alright, so the Seraph sees it. There's an Apis there. Skat. Let's get a condenser vein gone. Acid, sure. And then let's actually hop right next to them. Maybe wasn't the smartest idea. The acid cloud's pretty nice though. Yeah, we'll just keep unraveling if they're gonna keep doing what they're doing. Well, in terms of what we're probably going to do on this character, we have really, really, really low point. So, we do have a transmutation manual that could take us up some, and we do have necromutation available to us, but the success rate on that, yeah, it'll make us immune to torment, but not really the right character to be trying to do a 15 run. So, let's see what's in this treasure vault. There's a gateway out, which is nice. Helm seed is basically thing that we really need. And let's just auto-explore everything just to make sure we've got it all. Well, that is, it's a good point. I mean, if you're trying to do a 15 rune, like, if there's no penalty, why would you not go for necromutation? Like, you could spend your time dying and making a new character that's more appropriate to the end game, or you could spend your time making your current character good at it. I think it's a pretty good, balance. As for this character, I can't believe that we haven't found an awesome kite shield. I mean, ours is already pretty okay. So, man, we made a lot of progress. We've got our sixth rune. So we're gonna pass through this gate. And we're gonna park ourselves here on Zot. And perhaps in our next segment, we'll try and get down to Zot 5. So anyhow, thanks for watching. Until next time. Alrighty, welcome back to the stream. We are a stormy frog with twice the number of runes necessary to win. And we're going down into Zot. Alright, so that one is complete. Alright, 5 charges of Dig. I'm gonna make sure to take out that moth of her ass. Nice scroll of poison. We made good use of that in the ziggurat we went to. Thank you. Alright. So we are partway through clearing Zot 4. We are actually now done clearing Zot 4. Necromutation is a 2/3 spell success. So in order to cast it, we would need a lot more experience. Impossible though. What's our spell power on Dispel Undead? Not bad. We could always try and go back to Pan. We probably need to forget some spells. Like, we're really not using Animate Armor very much. Manifold Assault has its use, I suppose. Passage of Galubria, maybe we should be using more. Yeah, I don't see any obvious ones to just say, no, we don't want this, besides maybe Animate Armor. So that would give us some spell slots. Anyhow. On to Zot 5. So, classic Zot 5 layout. Let's make sure we exclude those so we don't just wander into them. Golden Dragon goes down, big deal. Let's get a blink in. See, that worked out well. Alright, well, hopping can lead you on top of a trap. And in this case, we got ourselves paralyzed, but that's okay. It's pretty safe. So now begins the somewhat slow process of trying to clear Zot 5. The main thing that you have to be very, very careful about is not exploring too quickly. Because if you go down one of these areas, see, it's like a tunnel that opens up into a bigger cave. When you start getting close to the entrance of the big rooms, you end up seeing a lot of the other space, and then an enemy jumping into some sort of a teleport trap, suddenly you find yourself out in the middle of that cave where you are not wanting to be. So having some patience is important. Just remember to use our main number. Alright, three hits and got the any magic. So, yeah, look at that. The Quicksilver Dragon Scales do basically two hits, each are 1d50, or thereabouts. It might be d48 or d51. So it actually has the potential to do some nice edge damage. Orb of Fire. Okay, so we've got the max fire resist, which is good. First, let's hop far away. And let's break line of sight. So at the very least, we don't have many turns fighting them. Let's go ahead and get a Mana Viper, and let's animate our armor. And let's cast a freezing cloud. We can't. There's already clouds there. Yes, we are going to cast freezing cloud. Okay, well, that doesn't look like it's working out very well. Whatever it is. No, it's not an orb of fire. It's just clouds. Yep. Let's just put the freezing clouds up. Lots of mountain tunes. We don't have many heal wounds anyhow, so mutation is not so bad. At least that's how we will choose to think about it. First toe, okay. Hop away, break line of sight. Go down a soft trap. Okay, it's all the way up there. So, miscast or Mana Viper, that's okay. Mana Viper, wow. Basically 1v1. Very nice. Thank you. so this is pretty bad. We're gonna try and hop away. It's a good use for cooking. Go ahead and get a freezing cloud here. All right, and use a blank scroll, but not too bad. That's the other thing that can happen is you have these transmitters blinking all around. So just like always, the goal is to be basically as close to your maximum health. Especially once you're thinking about trying to engage enemies. Let this orb of fire. We'll use a fog scroll to buy us a little extra time. The thing is, if we do a phantom mirror, it's not going to do much because it's immune to fire. Cold will do some damage to it. Acid will do damage to it. We're going to cast an irradiate, and then we're going to cast an acid, and then we're going to try and melee. Alright, that worked out. We got Berserk Itis. I hate Berserk Itis. Berserk can be really, really useful, but it's also extremely dangerous, so you gotta. There we go, we got stat rot, minus 10% MP, but we got 2 armor class and 2 dexterity, which ended up giving us some evasion. Another scroll of fog. We've got to get into a hallway. Sure that we're fighting. It's bizarre. Alright, so this is when we open here. And now we have our own bizarre tentacle monstrosity. It's upheaval on the north of ground. We can't do it again. Mutations from them. If there's any place where there's going to be Orb of Fire, this is really what you would expect. Oh, two Orbs of Fire. I'm gonna mine. Manifold assault. Let's read cloth potion of magic. Do some more manifold assault. We've got teleportitis, which is super bad for us. Mutation is at 36% though. And it would be at 11% if we put on a kite shield. The low HP kinda sucks, but you shouldn't be getting that low on HP anyway. And we've seen the Mana Viper 1v1 at Krusta before. Nice. There was an Orb of Fire up here. Lots of enemies, but I don't necessarily know where to go. But we can deconstruct here and make some noise. Maybe that'll help. Orbs of Fire, so we're going to use another Haste Potion. 3 Orbs of Fire. Okay. We should maybe use a Blink Scroll. Or a Teleport Scroll. We can maybe get in here. That's what we'll try to do. So, Alright, so we made it in. Let's condenser vein and hope for acid. That's not gonna work. If we're clever with how we dig, we dig here. We actually can create a little kill hole almost. Maybe. Have to use money. We should have used that before. Full salt every time two of them are on the screen. Alright, it's not really the best kill hole, but it's pretty decent. Go ahead and set this as a waypoint. That's the save. And then we'll have the intermediate save. These are better guidance. Consider this our meat spot. And that's our second. Okay. So we'll hop down here. Preserved. You definitely didn't want to misclick that. Alright. It's really not good to be in next to this net trap, but guessing that enemies don't even get caught in them anymore. Neck mutation of 30%. there's really nothing coming. Let's just make sure. Okay, I don't see anything. So what we've done is we've basically set some waypoints and then we can keep coming back to the exact same spot. Let's go back to one. Okay, well there's something there. Why we came over? Here's the orb. So if we got torment immunity, which we could do if we switch to a kite shield, then that makes other parts of the game easier, but the thing is, we still don't have huge big burst DPS. Like, you know, we're at 55 damage rating, which is fine, but it's not like, let me take out Asmodeus, in my opinion. Can be done. Has been done. But when we look at the way our character is operating, we do a solid amount of damage, and we can do that damage in AoE around us. And like, that's what our focus is transporting our damage into AoE damage. And what we don't have is a way to say, I'm gonna all of a sudden do tons and tons of damage. So like, Dragon Form would do it. High level conjurations would do it. Spellforge, Servitor, and Iron Shot would do it. Maybe. But we just put a whole bunch of stuff, a whole bunch of experience into Necromancy, so that's not relevant. Because we're basically at the point where we need to get into the extended part of the game. And we could do that. We'd lose some resist negativity, but we would be able to cast Necromutation. If we swapped our rings out, we could get more intellect and permanent fly. Let's do that. Let's do that. So we're at 44 shield rating. And we're gonna put on this. And now we went to 30, so that's a difference of 14. And then if we use all of our scrolls and chain armor, we can get to where it needs to be. It would be better to find a kite shield of resistance, but we haven't found it yet. Alright, and that's as much as we can. As much as we can do it. Necromutation's at 14%. And if we swap out this ring, we now only have one pip of resist cold, but necromutation is castable 11%. We need 5 spell levels. So we could forget Lee's rapid deconstruction. That sounds pretty good. Everything else we're using. Otherwise, we'd have to forget 2 spells. So if we forget 2 spells, we'd forget Passage of Calubria and Animate Armor. So let's just forget 1. We use Rapid Deconstruction. And then let's memorize Necromutation. So let's see what happens when you cast it. And same amount of health, and yeah, but with Lich Form, we're susceptible to holy magic, but we're also can't use any potions. None. No might, no haste. But we can end transformation pretty easily. It doesn't affect any of our equipment. Just means susceptible to holy. Can't use potions. So, for us in particular, we miss out on invisibility, curing, heal wounds, magic, might, haste, cancellation. It's a lot to miss out on. Yep, it is. But Torment Immunity is pretty nice. It also means, it's like, really? Do we really want to do this? Now that we have Necromutation? Do we really want to try and go for all the runes as Kazlal? I don't think so. But it's kind of cool to at least have it castable. If we put on the tower shield, Necromutation's at 19%. Well, we'll keep putting points into it, I guess, but it's not really gonna matter. Even though we have Necromutation, just let's grab this orb. almost kind of the depths. Pretty straight path out of dungeon 15. Still on which one? So we don't have to worry about this ice being too much. We'll dig another path through 13 to 12. We'll read a teleport scroll. Hope to get closer, which we do. On 11, we spawn next to an escape patch. We'll read a teleportation. We teleport 4 minutes away from the staircase. Now we're on dungeon 9. Let's go ahead and haste up. Dungeon 7. Taste ourselves again, swim through the water, we're on dungeon 5, we have a long way to go, so let's teleport. Didn't end up any closer. The pandemonium orb. Cloud of acid, potion of might, bill working on our skin, radiate. It seemed to work out okay. Alright, big battle on dungeon 5. Let's teleport again. Nice. Now we're on dungeon 3. Dungeon 2. Let's do ourselves again. So we're on dungeon 1. There's blood saints trying to block our path. But we dig through. We hop away. And just like that, our storm frog, the conqueror Barachi of Kazlal, has finally found a staircase leading out of the dungeon. There's a quote on the staircase leading out of the dungeon, T.S. Eliot. "We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time." So, up out of the dungeon we go. This is our storm frog, dedicated to my sister. So, on this game, we started out maces and foils. We went to a random altar. It was an altar to an unknown god. We had no choice in the matter, and we were assigned Kazlal. We ended up a manual of spellcasting, and that was the impetus for us to swap over into spells. So we used our manual of spellcasting, and then we got Yara's Violent Unraveling and Irradiate up. So that was a lot of different spell schools. So we also shortly thereafter picked up Summon Mana Viper. We also got Manifold Assault. Wasn't awesome for us, but we did use it. And then we got Freezing Cloud. So that was nice. We found some pretty decent gear. Pretty decent level of consumables. We got through roughly a dozen levels of the Ziggurat, maybe a little bit more. We got 6 runes. It's the first of our Kazlaw wins. And right now we have the top 42 high score on this. Yeah. Top 42 with 3 million points and 115,000 turns. First Baraji win. First Kazlaw win. Yeah. So, thanks for watching.